Well, welcome, guys. Welcome to the bonus stuff of Dot Hack Mutation. Okay, so we've completed the game, so let's see what we can do now that the game's been completed. The reverse city in the sky. No one knows its true name or what happened to its residents. For the secrets, head to Bitter Fantasy Mirror World and see with your own eyes. Okay, so that's our bonus dungeon. And that's just another email saying, congratulations, you completed the game. You can keep playing, but the plot won't continue until the next game. I'm not even going to read these. They're not very interesting. Okay, so we got one more golden goblin that we can chase after now. Now, this golden goblin, I actually took a bit of time to prepare for it. Because this one can be tough. Alright, so let's head to Detestable Vengeful Giddy. Bring it on, Martina R. Alright, so what we need to do is we need to get rid of her magic tolerance, which I bought some beast banes for. Okay, good, it landed. So her magic tolerance doesn't mean anything. Alright, then I got her.
You're good. I ask again, how about becoming a goblin? Goblins are nice. Gob.
No thank you, Martina.
I see you're not interested. How unfortunate, Gob. You have so much potential. Equip all Gob R series items. Something good will happen, I think. Gob. Okay, see you again. Gob.
So we got Imp's praises. Praises you in a very sloppy handwriting. Okay, then. Now that's actually the first time I've ever beaten her. So, go me. But I tried to do it the normal way, just fighting her with physical attacks. Her physical defense is so high, and once she casts regen, just you don't have any hope of beating her with physical attacks, unfortunately. All right, so I'm gonna sell these things off because I'm probably never gonna use them again. I bought them just in case, really. Okay, so she gave us an item that once we have all the goblin equipment on, I think we can summon a level 2 goblin this time instead of a level 1. It's still not very useful, and I'd probably never use it, but it's the thought that counts. Okay, so I'm going to call Sanjiro.
Oh, it's you!
And I'm going to call Wise Man.
Why, hello there. Give me just a moment. I'll be right there.
And I'm also... But yeah, I'm gonna call Sandro and Wiseman. That way we have a Steve Bloom party. Alright, so let's work... Actually, first, let's head to Makanu. Because I can get the final cutscene at Hidden Forbidden Holy Ground. Might as well get that out of the way first. Oh, one thing I did do before I started recording is, once again, I better equipped my party members, especially Wiseman. Made sure to give him some good stuff.
If you both don't stop right there, then I won't be responsible for what happens next!
You go on ahead.
We meet again. Stand still.
Huh. So that was Krim fighting Sora.
Is this a player's memory left behind in the world as well? I wonder what they're doing now.
Memory of a long arm and another silver Grunty. Now that is the final cutscene that you can get here at Hidden Forbidden Holy Ground. Oh, and we can also examine the items that they gave us. Instead of dwelling on the fact that I can't log out, just think that I don't have to. After all, now I don't have to return to that ludicrous world. I like it this way, it's not so bad. The Key of the Twilight, you want that, am I correct? I just want to fight it before anyone else. I have no interest in the item itself. So I'll give it to you, but... We don't even have an idea of where this large flow is coming from or why, but there are many who have noticed it. I'm afraid that the descendants of Fianna, Balmung of the Azure Sky, and Orca of the Azure Sea have... The key to overturning everything, a god that tries to reset this world. I don't like it. I have no intention of being the right-hand man for such a god. But yes, that long arm that was fighting Sora was called Krim. Krim is pretty cool. Looks like he was fighting off Sora to protect Tsukasa. Anyway, let's get started with the bonus dungeon of this game. Let's go, you two. So let's head to Bitter Fantasy Mirror World. So this has the same music that the bonus dungeon in the first game had, at least for this outside area. This area does look kind of cool though, I guess. But yeah, get used to seeing Wiseman in the party, because starting with .hack Outbreak, we're going to be using him a lot more often. And there's a reason for that. I won't go into it now, but you'll see soon enough. Okay, anyway, let's buff up. Okay, that'll be good. Let's start exploring this place. See what you turn into, Mr. Breathworm. This place is pretty crap treasure, as far as equipment anyway. I'd really like to fight more enemies instead of getting treasure. That's more like it. That thing is called a house golem, and it has physical tolerance. Come on, don't start giving me virus cores again, Kane. Just want some good stuff. Something good. That's not something good, game. Game is being kind of mean to me at the moment. Usually in the final dungeons of these games, and in the bonus dungeons, that's where you can get, like, ultimate weapons and stuff for your party members by data draining the enemies. Usually, anyway. Definitely getting unlucky with all of these treasure drops. Why can't I get this lucky in, like, the final bonus dungeon of Quarantine? That's someplace where it'd actually be helpful. Now we're going Sandro. Whoa. King Worm, huh? It's actually kind of creepy. That's how you pronounce it? Hmm. Interesting. everything is a katana, Sandro, you know? To the third floor now. I think it should be the last floor of this dungeon. Up ahead is the boss. I'm gonna take just a moment for my guys to heal. I'm gonna reapply buffs in the meantime.
There's something in the back. What the? It's acting like the boss of this ghost town.
Yikes. That's a big enemy. Anglemar.
Rajuksa. Try. jukes up.
Now this thing does hit pretty hard. Especially when it's using its special attack like that. Let's data drain this fool. Got Crimson Raid.
This is the thing that destroyed the city?
Have lucky shoes. Neat. So we got Crimson Raid and lucky shoes. So lucky shoes are pretty cool. They teach both Rig-Geem and Rig-Same. So we can recover both SP and HP over time with these. Probably gonna become my new boots to wear over my time sandals. As for the weapon, the Crimson Raid teaches Abvax, Twin Dragons, and Blazing Wheel. Now that I have that, I can probably get rid of Hyakidoran. Yeah, I think that'll do. Right, now let's go to the Lambda server. I'm gonna put a keyword in, that is, I believe that it's found on the Liminality DVD. Let me see if this is right. Alright, it's Capricious. Unending. Corridor. Yeah, Capricious Unending Corridor. Yeah, this is another one of those areas that you only find out about if you have the DVD, I guess. But again, I just looked it up. Now, I believe in the dungeon in this place, you can find another item to trade to an NPC. And I think it gets you, like, a really powerful lance for one of your long arms. But just like an infection, I'm not going to go through the dungeon, I'm just showing you where it is. So if you wanted to go through it, you can. Okay, so now that I'm here, it's time for Grunty Raising. And I think that'll be the last thing that I do before I stop. Okay, so there's two more Grunties that I can raise here in the Lambda server, and one other in the Feta server. Okay, let's see here. For the first one, I'm going to need 9 Ono Melons. Four Piney Apples. Three Snaky Cactuses. And then 9 Golden Eggs. was wrong. I think I'm close, though. I think he said... Yeah, he wants to eat a La Pumpkin again. And a root vegetable. That's not exactly what I wanted, but okay. Let's see if I can make the right one this time.
Dad!
Alright, for this one, I'm going to need... 4 piney apples again. Three sneaky cactuses. One invisible egg. And 11 golden eggs.
Ribbit, ribbit! Oh, Master! Thank you!
Ribbit!
Thanks to you, I've become an adult!
Ribbit!
I must repay my debt to you!
Ribbit!
Master?
Okay.
What is it?
This one's a little weird looking.
Master? You're extra red today!
Ribbit!
This one doesn't have anything I really want, to be honest. Back to the Lambda server, and let's see if I can make that other Grunty this time.
Dad!
Okay, so for this Grunty, I need 4 cordyceps. Two piney apples. Yeah, one mandragora. One snaky cactus. And 17 golden eggs. Okay, so we have a bony Grunty now.
Master, what is it? I'll trade you a rich and smooth item for a thick, yummy one.
Now this guy has some good stuff to trade. I'll have to get some trade fodder. That should be good, I think. Okay, good. Let's look at the Rio books real quick, as I haven't done that in a while. But yeah, I was trying to make, I think it's called a Snakey Grunty, but for whatever reason it didn't work out that time. Oh well. From the Grunty Ranch. In the towns where you've raised every type of Grunty, you can now enter them in a flag race. Register at the Grunty Ranch, so aim to become the fastest Grunty race in the world. I'm not going to show that this time, just because, you know, it's not something I really want to do right now. But yeah, the only way you can race is once you've raised every type of Grunty in that server. So we can only race in the Lambda server once we get the Snakey Grunty as well. Let's go ahead and use those items. Alright, and I think that'll bring Dot Hack Mutation to an end, folks. But yeah, now that I've completed Dot Hack Mutation, I think I'm gonna take a bit of a break from the Dot Hack series. Just because I'm enjoying it a bit more than I thought I would, but it's just, if I were to go straight into the other two games right at this point, I think I would get tired of it fairly quickly. So, I'm going to be recording other games in the meantime, but I'm definitely going to finish the series at some point. So, don't you worry about that. But, for now at least, that's going to be it from me and from Kite here. So, hope you enjoyed Dot Hack Mutation, and I'll see you guys in the next game, Dot Hack Outbreak. Until then, ominous out.